Hello my friends, in this video I'm gonna show you how to create relational database in MySQL. So first of all, open MySQL database management system, and first let's create a database. So my menu here, my navigation here, everything is in Russian language, but I'll be explaining in English. So first create a database. So let's call this database test 2. Click on create. So test 2 database appeared on the left side, as you can see here. So click on that database, and now I want to create three tables: customers table, orders table, and products table. So let's start with customers table. So I have six attributes here. So customers, number of columns 6. Click on go. So first we have customer ID. So type will be integer, and index should be primary, and AI, you have to put a tick here. AI means auto increment. So next, first name, text, let's say 30, length, we can put, I'll put 30, you can put whatever you want. Next, so last name, customer phone, last name, text as well, 30, customer phone, text, say 30, customer phone, and customer email. Oops. And customer email. So let's make it text as well. 30, and so that's it. So if I leave this one just empty, nothing will happen. System will create a table customers with 5 attributes. So but why do I have only 5? Oh yeah, excuse me, here 5 as well. So it finish. Now let's scroll down and click on save. So save. So one table is ready. As you can see, it's appeared in my database. So here, customers table. So let's create second table. Second table will be orders. So there are 5 attributes as well. Orders, 5 columns, order ID, integer, index primary, auto increment, yes. Then I need to write customer ID and product ID. Customer ID, product ID, customer ID, product ID, then prod quantity and order date. Prod quantity, and order date. So order date, let's choose date, prod quantity, let's leave it integer. So here customer ID and my product ID, they both will be foreign keys. That's why we don't have to put here primary. So finish, let's click save. Okay, good. Next, now we have to create our last table, products table. So products, so we have three columns. Product ID, product name, and product producer. Oops, producer. So product ID will be primary key and auto incremented, and product name, let's put text 30, and producer, let's put text as well 30. Okay, good, ready, click on save. Well, so now we have three tables here, and now I'm gonna create a relationship between these tables. So in order to create a relationship, first of all I will create a relationship, as you can see in this image. So there will be relationship one to many from customers to orders table, and one to many from products to orders table. It means that one customer may have lots of orders, and one product also may appear in lots of orders. So in order to do this, click on orders table, then go on structure, and here in structure we have to click on for customer ID and product ID, we have to click on index. So click index for customer ID. Oh, it says everything is correct. So, and click on index for product ID as well. So here, so I'm clicking on index. Okay, so I clicked on index for product ID and customer ID in orders table. Okay, so now after that we have to go to this relationships connections. So click on that. Okay, so now in order to make a connection, we have to, so we want to connect our customer ID which is in customers table, with customer ID and product ID, which is in products table, with product ID. So that's it. Okay, now click on save. waiting. Well, I think it's saved though. If you save that, now click on your database test 2. So database, click on database test 2, then go to more. Here you should have such kind of a menu, more option, and go to designer. So click on designer. So now in designer view, in designer menu, you can see how the those tables are related to each other. So as you can see, products table have relationship one to many to orders table, and customers table has a relationship one to many to orders table as well. And so everything is connected properly and should work without any problems. So in order to check that, let's add some, let's populate our tables with some data. So first of all, open the customers table and go to insert. Let's insert some data. So let's say first name will be Arman, last name will be Smakov, for example. The phone number, just any number, and email arman@mail.com, for example, and click on go. Okay, and let's add one more, Samat. First name, last name will be Asanov. Phone number, any number. Email, let's say asan@mail.com. Let's add here this third person. Timur, last name Ahan. Oops. Oh, excuse me. Something. It's not working well in my computer. Oh, but now it's okay. So, phone number, email, ahan@mail.com. So now let's click on go. Okay, so I've added three customers into my customers table. So now let's go to products table, open the products table, and insert into products table some products. So first let's add bread, for example, producer, Kazakhstan. And second product, apple juice. Producer Almaty, and click on go. Okay, so now let's go and have a look. So this is our products table. So as you can see here, we have bread, producer Kazakhstan, apple juice Almaty, and we have IDs here, product IDs 1 and 2. Now let's have a look at customers table. So This is our customers table. We have three records in customers table. First is Arman, last name Smakov, customer phone, email. So ID is correct, 1, 2, 3. So it's auto incremented. Next. Now I want to, for example, go to orders table and populate this orders table with some data. So I want, for example, let's say customer ID, whose ID is 1, 2, let's say, bought product ID second. So as you remember, second is a juice, apple juice. So second person who is ID 2 in customer's table bought an apple juice. So next, product quantity, let's say 2 items. Date, we can choose from here, let's say this. So let's add one more. Now let's say customer 1 bought apple juice as well. Quantity 5 items. Okay, now let's click on go. Okay, save. So now let's have a look at our orders table. So here, as you can see, order ID 1, 2, customer ID 2, product ID, customer ID, customer whose ID is 2 bought a product with ID 2. And from this table we can see actually who is, for example, customer ID. If we just click on this number on 2, so I'm clicking on that. So if I click, as you can see here, we can get all the information about customer with ID 2. So it's a Samat Asanov. And now let's have a look to, let's open again our orders table, and now let's try to do the same thing with product. So so we can see that product with ID 2, and if we click on this 2, so we can see that product with ID 2 is apple juice. So and it means, so this is how relational tables works and relational database. So and it makes data not to be rewritten a lot of times. So it you can just get rid of redundant data if you use relational database. So actually it's not so difficult. So if you want to see again this relationship tables, this diagram of related tables, you just have to click on database, on your database one more time, then here you should have some option more, and there you have, you can find a designer. If you click on designer, here you will find your tables. So thank you for watching. Hope this video was